If you have students who are currently attending more public schools, it is required for all parents to have an Infinite Campus Parent Portal account. You will need an activation code to create your Parent Portal account. If you have a student in elementary, you will need to contact your school secretary and present your driver's license or military photo ID to obtain your activation code. If you have a student in junior high or high school, you can email your photo ID to portal@moreschools.com to request an activation code. The email you use must be the email address that was on file with your school. If you no longer have access to that email account, you will need to contact your school secretary and present your photo ID in person to receive your activation code. You will need to use a desktop or laptop computer to create the Parent Portal account. Once your account is created, you can download the app on your phone and log in, but the initial account creation works best on a computer. Once you have your activation code, you're ready to begin. Open your computer browser and visit our district website at www.moreschools.com. Scroll down to the More Resources section and find the Parent Portal link listed under the For Our Parents column. Select the Campus Parent button. Find the new user link in the bottom left of the login window. This is where you will need to type in the activation code that your school provided you when you requested the Parent Portal account and presented your photo ID. Now you will create your username and password. Now it's time to log in with your new username and password. When you log in for the first time, it will ask you to add a security email to your account. This email will be used if you ever forget your password and need to request a password reset. Now that you have created your Parent Portal account, let's explore the menu options. When you click today, you will see your student, their schedule for today, and their assignments that are due today. If you want to switch to a different student, click on the student image and name in the top right corner and you will see your other students listed there. By clicking calendar, you can see what assignments are due on specific days of the week. By clicking on assignments, you will see a list of all assignments, both graded and ungraded. You can narrow it down by missing assignments and current term assignments. By clicking on grades, you can see the students' grades in each class, and you can choose either first semester or second semester. By clicking on a specific class, you can get information about the teacher, the grade the student has, and any upcoming assignments they may have. By selecting gradebook updates, you will see any recent updates to scores or assignments posted. When you select attendance, you can see how many times the student was either absent or tardy for each class in either first or second semester. You can also look at your student's schedule, and you can see if there are any fees associated with each class. Documents will provide you with links to their progress reports and report cards. And the More option gives you information about important dates, information about their locker if they have one, and MPS portal info like their state testing number. You can also get access to the More Public Schools website from this page as well. In the top left, you will see the Message Center where you can see the most recent announcements. You will also see three lines where you can condense the menu options on the left if you choose to. In the top right, you will see your profile icon where you can adjust your settings for your account. Here you can choose your notification settings. You can decide under what circumstances you want to be notified. Make sure you click Save at the bottom anytime you make any changes. You can also adjust your account settings and add any additional security emails if you choose to. Once you select Contact Preferences, you can select your preferred language, and you can also decide what type of notifications you would like to receive for each type of contact method. Now that we are finished looking at settings, if you will click your profile icon, you will see the language option. Here you may choose what type of language you would like Infinite Campus to be displayed in. In the top right corner, you will also find the notification icon where you can access the Message Center. Anytime you've read your notifications, you can mark them all as read. And finally, when you're ready to log off, click the profile icon to find the log off link. I hope this has been helpful. Please let us know if you have any questions.